Welcome back. Now I'm going to go ahead and let you watch me do the erasing on the petals. That's where this falls into place anyway, so you want to be sure and do this now. But you'll get to watch me do that, and then we'll come back and do some of the darker pinks. Got everything nice and dry, and I've got my eraser out. I use a Faber-Castell dust-free, which I like. And I'm just going to start, see what I'm doing here, erasing any lines. Now the dark will help cover up as we go into the mid value and the dark value, but if we can erase some of these lines, now is the time to do it. This is such a light value rose that you don't want those pencil lines to show if you can help it. Now it probably sounds like I'm really scrubbing, but I'm not. Arches paper is very good at allowing us to do this. But if you do it too harshly, you can raise the nap of that paper and then you have to take your kitchen towel and put it down, and I call it a button, but it's actually a little smooth stone. I bought it right at Walmart in the floral section. But if you had raised the nap on that, you would just take your little stone and go over it. And Arches is so good. The paper is just phenomenal. It smooths it right down and it allows you to paint on that area without being able to see that there was a problem there. It's always good to learn how to fix your mistakes. That's important. I learned that being a teacher, you have to know how to fix a student's mistakes. And your own. Because we all make them. But if you don't get your eraser or your pencil marks off now with your eraser, it's going to be even harder later on once more paint gets applied. More paint on top of that pencil line makes it more difficult to get off. I always had a hard time when I first started doing watercolors to remember to do that. Because with oils, it just covers everything right up. You don't have to worry about this. So I wasn't used to doing it. And oil's got its value too. It's got a lot of depth. You can put white right on top of black if you need to. It might take a couple coats, but you can certainly do it. Well, that's not the case with watercolor, so that was another thing I had to get used to, is save your whites. Either mask them out or basically jump them like we are now. In acrylics, I used blending and glazing medium with that, made for acrylics. Okay, we've got everything erased on our pretty flower. So now what we're going to do is go ahead and put in our medium values and then our dark values. And this is going to be wet on dry, so you will not see me adding water to the paper at all. So go ahead and watch me. You're going to get to see a couple different areas applied.
and then I'll be back with you.
That's wet. Because when we lay this down wet on dry paper, you want to be able to go back in with a wet brush and soften the edge. Okay, so I've got the mid value. And we're going to go petal by petal. Now, to me, this shadow, it's the dark value down here, and then the mid value up here. The outside lines are not soft, so they're not softened in. So we're going to put that in first. I'm going to put the entire shadow with the mid value first, and then we'll put the dark value right on top of it. This shadow comes right up to the edge of this petal, and this is wet on dry. We're not going to soften the edges because we don't want that shadow to blend away. We want it to look like a shadow. And a shadow can and does have hard lines. So that's our lighter value up there. Now I'm going to pick up the darker value while it's still moist and drop that in down here. And it's still wet enough, it should soften in up above. Not outside the shadow, but up above. Okay, so we've got that first shadow in. Let's go ahead and put the rest of these shadows in. We've got to fill in this petal too, so we'll do that as well. Shadow here. Got the first one in. We're going to put a shadow here and a shadow here, and we're going to fill in that petal. Let's fill in that petal first. Now it goes right from about right there and then up before you get to here. So that petal, keep my hands out of that shadow. The only difference in value in this petal is the two. There's no highlight in it. I shouldn't say shadow, it's actually a petal. So this again is going to look just like a shadow with the outside edge. There's going to be some streaking in it, so when we're done filling in, we'll go back in and do some streaking this way. Now, let's go ahead and pick up our dark value, our darkest value. And of course the corners are always going to be an area that you need to put your dark value in. I don't care what you're painting. Alright, right there. And then we're going to jump over that little bump there and we're going to just put this in right up in there. Okay, there's
areas with the medium value and the dark value. Now I'm going to go to the front petal again so you can see me do the dark values. So you'll get to watch me do that as well. Just one moment.
So we're going to bring some of these colors down like this. Don't want to cover up all of your peach color. Again, that's your value. Soften my brush. Clean my brush, soften in these values here a little bit. That one's a little harsh. I'm going to pick up some of that color a little bit in comparison to what's around it. That's better. See, now this bud is growing in this fashion, so that's why we're getting streaks in this fashion, the way we're putting them in now. So we're going to take our dark value, because we've got a real dark edge right here and right in that triangle area, which is right here. I'll start there. That's the dark value. Now it's just wet enough that this is going to soften in, and it doesn't have to soften in real much. So it's pretty dark in these areas. Bringing this to life. Slowly but surely. There we go. Okay, now let's see. Darker value. And we need to do this just to separate that. Darken that corner up a little bit. It helps separate that front petal. Making sure everything's going in the right direction.
Well, now we're going to go ahead and add in the purple values to the petals. So you'll get to see me apply that, and then we'll move on from there.
Not quite enough. Soften those edges, just like that. Now, there is some in this area too, so we're going to put that in. I'm running out of color here, so I'm just going to pick up some of what I need and create some more of that purple. Alright, so we've got right up against this outside edge here. And then we do have just a little bit of streaking in here. Looks so harsh when you first put it down. But you can always fix whatever you mix up. Checking my photograph, make sure I'm heading in the right direction here. It looks like I am. We could even bring a little bit of that right in here. I'm going to soften this out a little bit too with that purple. That'll soften some of those harsher lines in there. Yeah, it's starting to look good. Okay, we're going to dry this. And then when we come back, we're going to let the flower settle for a little while. We're going to have to darken this in with the yellow. I can see that already, but that's okay. We're going to, that'll be our details. We're going to dry this real good, and then when we come back, we're going to start on our leaves. So I'll see you then.